Thank you. Let's go ahead and recap now what we've seen here to this point. Vice President Joe Biden making the announcement this morning, research foundation for SUNY will be the hub for a new manufacturing institute in integrated photonics. This institute is expected to bring $610 million in public-private investment and create thousands of jobs in the Rochester area, marking the largest public-private commitment to date in our region. My colleague Adam Chodak standing by once again inside the Canal Ponds manufacturing facility. Adam, what do you have right now?
What role the universities and colleges in our area are going to play in this center? And with me now to answer that question a little bit more elaborately than I could, we have RIT's president, Bill Destler. Bill, what role did you play leading up to this announcement?
Actually, the three core universities involved in preparing the proposal were SUNY Poly, the University of Rochester, and RIT. That's because the governor wanted very much for the effort here to be focused in Rochester and to take advantage of the assets we already have in photonics, imaging, and optics here in the region. And, of course, University of Rochester is a famous institution in optics, probably world famous. RIT is actually surprisingly strong in imaging science. And so we have complementary strengths in the whole area that relate to photonics. And both of us will be very significant players. We're going to actually get significant funding out of the initiative. Those will result, of course, in more jobs in our sector. But I think even more importantly, we will become centers that will attract companies from around the country and around the world who want to be near all of this activity.
Will we see U of R representatives or RIT representatives on the board of this institute?
Oh, yes, of course, yes. In fact, the next thing that's going to happen is we have to get ourselves organized, and there will be an overall steering committee to have representatives from U of R and RIT on it. There will also be various kinds of lower-level operating committees of various kinds, and we'll have representatives on those as well.
A lot of people are wondering about the logistics of all this, how it will play out, where this is going to be headquartered. Do you know any of that?
Well, Joel Seligman and I are arguing that we locate the headquarters at the Sibley Building. We are actually very interested in supporting the city and in creating a kind of downtown innovation zone. And as you know, RIT already has a downtown center right next to the Sibley Building where we have our Center for Urban Entrepreneurship. And we've moved a couple companies in there already. U of R is going to move the high-tech Rochester incubator into the Sibley Building. So we think that's a natural spot. So we'll be lobbying for that.
So it has not been settled then?
No, but I think we've got a good chance that it'll be down there.
You seem like a person in the position who can explain to people what photonics actually is.
Well, it's actually the use of light in integrated circuits. Interestingly enough, there's been a lot of talk about this for many years, but we're only now getting to the point where you can actually manufacture chips that have actually optical elements on them as part of the manufactured chip. And that's what this is all about, to turn this into an industry that produces real products, not just a research laboratory. And so we're very excited, and we'll be at the forefront of this huge emerging industry.
And RIT has been a leader in robotics, and from what I understand, photonics can be applied to robotics very easily.
Oh, without a doubt. And also, a big part of robotics now is imaging. And we're very, very good at that area as well. So I think we have many things to offer the program, and we'll be an important player. I think the U of R will be a very important player. And I think our region will be blessed with, I think, many opportunities that will come here because of this institute being located in Rochester. I expect to have dozens of companies fairly quickly show an interest in establishing operations right in this region just to be close to what's going on.
RIT President Bill Destler, thank you so much for your time, sir.
My pleasure.